Good evening, and welcome to our VCHS Fall Vocal Music Concert. Where's my applause sign? I was kidding. Hey, I'm so glad that you're here. It's been the first time in a minute that we've had a concert in this format. The last time we did one, we actually did it over in that area between those two buildings, you might recall. And it was kind of a standing only thing. Anyway, we're back in business. It's good to be having all the choir singing together. And I'm excited to share the music with you tonight. Before we jump into it, I was on leave, many of you guys know, for 4 weeks, and we had a baby boy. His name, appropriately, I named him Major. It was actually my wife's idea, but I loved it. And he's 8 weeks now, so we're still in the thick of it. So if one of my eyes starts switching or something, you'll know why. I'm not sleeping as much as I'd like to. In any case, I do mention that for a reason. It's because we have a guest director tonight. She stepped in to help me while I was on leave and helped run the choir. And it happens to be Mr. Q Thomas's wife, Rachel Thomas. So throughout the night, she's going to be, Throughout the night, she'll be guest directing one song from each choir. So anyway, we'll be sharing the podium tonight, and I'm happy to do so. We'll start off with a word of prayer. Please bow your heads with me. God, we thank you, and we truly are grateful for music and the chance to get together. Thank you for Valley Christian allowing us to do this. Thank you for the gifts and talents you bless all these students with and how you put it in their heart to sing and be part of choir. I pray that your blessings would just flow through this short and sweet concert, that you be glorified in all that we do, and we sure do give you praise and honor and glory. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Our first song tonight with the concert choir is Lonesome Valley.
Thank you.
Concert Choir is going to perform one more song for you called Stand in the Light. This will be conducted by Mrs. Rachel Thomas. Would you give her a hand, please? The last, about a week and a half ago, we had auditions for concert solos, and all the students performed in front of each other, not all of them, but those who are interested in possibly singing a solo for this concert, got to sing in front of their friends. And the reason I mention that is because I was really blown away at your children. They were so supportive of each other, and me and Mr. Q and Mrs. Thomas was there that day. And we were just, I don't know, we felt really good about our lives. It was just, every student would go, and there was just tons of positive reinforcement. I was just, people were raising their hands. It was like, all right, you go. And it was just like, oh, I just love your beautiful voice. Or just really meaningful kind word. So I just want to shout out to all the choirs and really to you, the parents, for raising great kids that support one another and all their singing. So with that, we did choose three people, one from each choir. And this is Alana Toledo, who's going to be singing a song called Distance, and she's part of our women's ensemble, which is up next. But take it away, Alana. That was fun. I like conducting that one. And my name happens to be Daniel, so I guess I just, you know, couldn't help but pick that song. All right, hey, we're going to invite Mrs. Rachel Thomas up again to do this song, You Say. While she steps up, yeah, you can give her a hand. It's great to have her. Yeah. This next song is going to feature soloists, Megan Patterson, Karen Townsend, Rain Reyes, Bella Warners, Alana Toledo, and Saraya Harvey. This is You Say.
Say I'm not enough.
We have one more piece from our women's ensemble for you. This piece, don't try to figure out what they're saying, because it literally, basically it's like a made up language, but it's a really cool sounding song. Got kind of a Latin text vibe. It's called Adiamus. And we have some help on percussion with Whitney Erickson on the cajon and Francie Leffler helping out on shaker over here as well. One more round of applause for our women's ensemble, please. Well done, ladies. All right, while they're walking off, I'll invite our next soloist up. This young man is in 10th grade, and he likes to sing musicals, and he's quite skilled at it. And hearing him audition in front of the class caught everybody's attention. So we're going to share that with you now. This is Burn from Hamilton, the musical, and it'll feature Xavier Davis. Welcome up, Xavier.
Saved every letter you wrote me. From the moment I read them, I knew you were mine. You said you were mine, I thought you were mine. Do you know what Angelica said when we saw your first letter arrive? She said, be careful with that one, love. He will do what it takes to survive. You and your words flooded my senses. Your sentences border on senseless. You built me palaces out of paragraphs. You built cathedrals. I'm rereading the letters you wrote me. I'm searching and scanning for answers in every line, for some kind of sign. And when you were mine, the world seemed to burn. Published the letter she wrote you. You told the whole world how you brought this girl into our bed. In clearing your name, you have ruined our lives. Do you know what Angelica said when she read what you've done? She said, you've married an Icarus. He has flown too close to the sun. Words obsessed with your legacy. Your sentences border on senseless. And you are paranoid in every paragraph how they perceive you. I'm erasing myself from the narrative. Let future historians wonder how Eliza reacted when you broke her heart. You torn it all apart, I'm watching it burn. Watching it burn. The world has no right to my heart. World has no place in our bed. They don't get to know what I said. I'm burning the memories, burning the letters that might have redeemed you. You forfeit all rights to my heart. You forfeit the place in our bed. You'll sleep in your office instead, with only the memories of when you were mine. I hope that you burn.
Thank you, Xavier. All right. Hey, next in our agenda tonight, we are going to take an offering, and if you like what's happening here and what we're doing with our program, I just encourage you to give. If it's a little too dim and you'd like us to have some lighting that's better, feel free to give. I'm sorry, I shouldn't have said that out loud. But in all honesty, give as your heart leads, and some of the boys will be passing around buckets as we hear our next soloist. Actually, our duet. This is going to be Samara Lee and Julia Vergen. They're going to be singing Rainbow Connection.
I know the wrong way to see. that and someone believed him. Look what he's done so far. What's so amazing and keeps us stargazing? What do we think we might see? Someday we'll find it, the rainbow connection, the lovers, the dreamers, and me. Have you been half asleep? And have you heard the voices? The sweetest sounds that calls the young sailors. Voice might be one and the same. I've heard them too many times to ignore it. It's something I'm supposed to be. Someday we'll find it, the rainbow connection, the lovers, the dreamers, and me. The lovers, the dreamers, and me.
Thank you. Thank you, ladies. We'll have the madrigals as they come up. I have a few announcements. We're still getting those buckets passed, but take your time, gentlemen. Not announcements, but some acknowledgments before we go any further while the madrigals make their way up to the stage. First off, shout out and thank you to Matt Dahlenberg and the VC maintenance crew for always helping us out and dragging these stages around and setting up all these chairs for you. So thank you. Appreciate it. Also, our audio technicians tonight, our students here at Valley, and that's Rachel Stender and Copper Abbott right here, so they're doing an awesome job. You know they're doing great when you haven't noticed them. You know, it's only when the feedback happens or something goes wrong that everybody wonders what's going on with the sound guy. So anyway, good job, you guys. Way to go. Also, a shout out and thank you to Mr. Cy Neal. He's video recording this entire thing with, if you haven't noticed, a few different cameras all over, actually. And he just, I have to say, he does it free of charge just because he, you know, loves this program so much and is just a really an asset to Valley. So thank you, Cy, for your time and your effort. For the record, I will post that on, I'll send that out in an email once he finishes editing it together. So any of you that are on the, well, all of you that are parents of the Madrigals and Women's Ensemble and Concert Choir students, you'll get that video eventually. Thank you to Troy Stahl and Chris Becker for this, you know, superintendent and assistant principal, and for all their support for the program. We can give them a hand. Thank you, Troy, wherever you are. And Chris. The first Madrigal song is actually going to be directed by Rachel Thomas, so I wanted to acknowledge her just one more time for her time and effort. And it's a whole month of teaching, and then now she's directing. So thank you, Rachel, for stepping in for that. And as she makes her way up, one more shout out. Of course, the biggest, I think, one of all goes to my accompanist, assistant director. He's the instrumental director at the school now, guitar class teacher, writer and arranger. I could go on forever, but this is Q Thomas on keys tonight. Okay, and we'll take it away with Madrigal singing a wonderful song called Plaudite, directed by Rachel Thomas.
Come,
legitimately hate to say, we have only one more song for the evening. I'm having a great time conducting them. Haven't all the choirs done great tonight? It's truly my pleasure to direct all these students. Our last song is, it might be my favorite of the set, hence I saved the best for last. This is a song called The Word Was God. It's text from the Gospel of John that you'll recognize, and it's just a really cool a cappella piece. I hope you enjoy. The Word Was God. A round of applause for all three groups for tonight's concert. And then one final applause, Mrs. Rachel Thomas, thank you for filling in so well while Dan was gone. And then Mr. Thomas, thanks for all that you do. I know it's more than just playing the keyboard, and you help keep this all these groups organized. Mr. Davis, thank you for organizing a great concert tonight. This really concludes our fall concert season, I believe, with the vocal music tonight. I want to put on your calendars, before we end in prayer, Tuesday, December 7. Last year we had a wonderful Christmas event planned with every musical group, I believe, middle high school, all the way down to 5th, 6th, set up all around this campus. For a Christmas kind of walking program, so to speak. Various groups will be playing at various times, so it's not just one group at a time. We have most of the logistics worked out, and we're really excited to try that. I think there's going to be coffee and hot chocolate and cookies, and it will be sort of a winter wonderland, as much as you can do that here in Southern California. So mark your calendars, Tuesday, December 7, and it will be here sooner than you think, okay? On my way in tonight, someone asked, can I help pick up chairs afterwards? Please, no. This is our chapel setup. If you didn't know that, we have chapel here at the high school every Wednesday, and we do it outside right now. So it is set up the way it needs to be, and our maintenance department would greatly appreciate if you don't mess with the count, okay? We finally got the count down after about 8 weeks, 10 weeks of school. So thank you for listening with that request.
Let's close our evening in prayer. Father God, we thank you for a wonderful evening of music. We thank you for the reminder that the Word was God and is God. And we know, Lord, for 87 years this place has been built on your Word. We pray that we would remain faithful to that calling to equip and inspire students to live a life of service to you. Thank you for that reminder tonight. We pray a blessing on everyone here. And Lord, thank you for all that you do for us as a school and for our families. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Drive home safely.